Namaste and a very good morning, dear children. I hope you're all ready for today's English class. Now, children, today we're going to do a poem and the name of the poem is On the Water. Now, this poem has been written by Anonymous. Anonymous means that we do not know the name of the poet. Okay, so come, let's begin with our poem. Now, in the poem, our poet is boating, okay, and he is having fun while observing the things around him, while looking at the things around him. So come, let's see what he says. In our little boat to glide, on the water, blue and wide, while the sky is smooth and bright, what could give us more delight? So the poet says, while we are boating in our little boat, to glide means that while our boat is moving smoothly and quietly on the water which is blue and wide means which is in a open and spacious lake, and the sky today while we are boating, the sky is smooth and bright. Bright means it's a sunny day, and smooth means it's a clear sky. Clear means there are no clouds. So he says, what more could I ask for to give me happiness? What more can we ask for happiness? Wide means broad, spacious, and delight means happiness. So the poet says that while we are moving in our boat smoothly on the water, which is blue in color and on a spacious river, and the sky on that day is quite bright and it's quite clear, what more can I ask for to give me happiness? I hope the first paragraph is clear. Let's move further. See the ripples, how they run. Can you see the ripples while this boat is moving in the picture? Can you see the ripples which are being formed? Ripples are, your children, a number of waves which are formed on the surface of the water due to breeze or when the boat is moving. Can you see the boat is moving and you know the waves are forming? These are your ripples. So he says, see the ripples, how they run. So while they're boating, he's saying, see, we can see the ripples, how they're moving, twinkling brightly in the sun. Twinkling means the ripples are shining. When the sun rays are falling on the ripples, it seems as if they are shining. Can you see in the picture? Here also it seems as if the ripples are twinkling. While reflected, we can see shadows of each hill and tree. And while reflected means on the water, we can see the reflection of all the hills and the trees which are near the river. While reflected, we can see shadows of each hill and tree means while on the water, we can also see the reflection, the shadows which are forming of the trees, of the hills which are nearby. Okay, so come, let's move to the next paragraph. See the lilies round and large. Now, children, in this paragraph, the poet is simply talking about the things which he sees near the river. Okay, the first thing that he sees are the lilies, which are round and which are big, which are large, and they are floating near the reedy marsh. Reedy marsh means, marge means the border, and reedy is your tall grass. Okay, I'll just show you the picture. Now, can you see on the border? Can you see the long grass that is there? This is reedy. These are called reeds. Okay, this tall grass is known as reeds, and border is the marge. Marge means border. Okay, where the bulrushes has its place and the heavy water maze. Now, bulrush is also your reedy marsh. It's a grass. Okay, I'll just show you how a bulrush looks. And water maze is also your water, you know, it's also a grass. I'll just show you. So reedy, a grass-like plant that grows near the edge of a river or lake. Can you see? Marge means border. Border means, I hope everyone knows what's a border. Now this is a bulrush. Okay, a tall reed-like water plant with a dark brown velvety cylinder. Can you see in the picture the cylinder, the brown cylinder that is there? like shape tiny flowers. And this is your maze. This is your water maze. So he has seen two, three things. He has seen the water lilies, which are floating towards the reedy marsh, and where bulrushes, these bulrushes also growing there, and the water maze is also growing there. Okay, at the border of the river. See the great green dragonfly. And he says, see, there's a great green dragonfly also. And I have attached the picture of the dragonfly also so that it becomes clear. And the swallow swimming by, skimming by. And your swallow, this is a swallow, it's a bird. Okay. And the swallow is also, what is the swallow doing? It is also skimming by. Skimming means moving quickly along the surface of the river, along the surface of the river, and he is just moving along the surface of the river. He's searching for probably fish. Okay, see the fishes spring and gleam, and the fishes in between, the fishes are also spring means they're jumping. Okay, they're jumping, and gleam means the fish are shining when they come out of the water. Means when they jump out of the water and the sun rays fall on them, it seems as if they are shining. They splash into the stream. Means before they splash, they go back into the stream. Splash means when something falls into the water, that sound comes, na, splash sound. So he says before they go back into the stream, into the river. See the bright kingfisher too. And first we saw a dragonfly also, then we saw a swallow, and now there's a kingfisher also who's trying to catch fish. Okay, so this is a kingfisher. Can you see the kingfisher, how fast it's moving to catch the fish? See, so he says dart gleam of great and blue. Dart means when you move or run somewhere suddenly. So see in the picture also, the kingfisher is moving so quickly. He's darting inside. Gleam, as I told you earlier also, shine of great and blue. It is shining of blue color. You know, it seems green and blue. They are all mixed and shining in the picture also, it seems. His colors, the colors of the kingfisher are very prominent in the picture also. They are all around our boat. And he says all these things are around our boat. Fine. On the water whiles we float. On the water whiles means while. At the same time, when we are floating on the we are floating on the water while we are boating, we get to see all these things. In a way, the poet is asking you to observe the nature, observe the things. That means look carefully at the things which are around you and enjoy the nature that is there around you. Okay, children. I hope the poem is clear to everyone. Thank you and have a nice day, children.